Hi, I'm Penny and this is Hattie and this is the Level 2 Probability Strategy video.
This paper breaks down into three main areas, which are probability trees, two-way tables and the normal distribution. Within those areas you'll be tested on a few general probability questions and also some specific skills including relative risk, conditional probabilities and describing and explaining histograms.
The good news is this paper is extremely predictable. The type of questions that you get every single year are fairly similar, so we're going to talk through some possible ways to tackle all of these questions as well as some overall advice for the paper. If you listen closely to this video, you'll probably ace the exam. For probability trees, there's three main things that you need to pay attention to. First is making sure that you have your probabilities in either a decimal or a fraction form. That makes it easier for you to multiply them together. If you're given it in a percentage, you just have to divide it by 100 to get it into a decimal. Secondly, when you have your probability tree and it goes off from a notch, all the probabilities that go off from that notch add up to 1. This is a good way for you to check if your answers make sense, and it's best to check it straight after you've filled out the tree rather than realize you made a mistake later on. Lastly, when you are multiplying probabilities together, you're working along a probability tree, and when you add them together, you're working down.
For two-way table questions, you should always start by filling in the totals, even if there isn't a space in the table for you to do that. It will make the rest of the question a lot easier. Two-way table questions also almost always include a relative risk question, which are probably the easiest excellence marks to get on the exam because they involve the least complex maths. So let's run through a simple example so you can be ready to lock down those E marks. They're usually phrased as a claim, so let's say the question said a newspaper states that group A is twice as likely to catch a cold as group B. So the first thing you need to do is calculate what's called the absolute risk, which is just a really fancy way of saying the probability for each group. In this particular case, the probability of group A catching a cold is 16 out of 40, which is 0.4, and the probability of group B catching a cold is 15 out of 60, which is 0.25. So those are our absolute risks. To make a relative risk, we just put them in a fraction. Group A came first, so it's on the top of the fraction, and group B is the group we're comparing to, so it goes on the bottom of the fraction. So we get 0.4 divided by 0.25, which comes out to 1.6. To finish off these questions, you write a context sentence. So you'd say, group A is 1.6 times as likely to catch a cold compared to group B. Then finally, relate it back to the actual question and say the newspaper was wrong because that's not twice as likely.
When you get a normal distribution question, the best way to start the question is to draw out a diagram. Label what you know and what you want to know, and then you can look at what you know and the best way to approach this question. For example, if you know the x value, the mean, and the standard deviation, then we're going to want to use our calculator and use the NCD function to calculate the probability. But if we know the probability, the mean, and the standard deviation, then we're going to want to use the inverse normal to then find the x value. The trickier one is when you're given the mean or the standard deviation and a probability, and they're asking you to find either the mean or the standard deviation that you don't know. Then what you have to do is you have to use the inverse normal and your z-score formula, and then you can solve it from there. Another typical question that you'll get with normal distributions is you'll get a histogram, and they'll ask you to determine whether this resembles a normal distribution or not. The best way to start this is to describe what a normal distribution is. So it's symmetrical, unimodal, and a bell shape, and then compare that to the histogram that you're given. If you want to get extra marks, the best way for you to do that is to then talk about what the mean, the mode, and the median is of that histogram. As we know, for a normal distribution, the mean, the mode, and the median are all going to be equal. For more information on how to do this, check out the StudyTime guides.
There are some skills that can come up in any kind of question, whether it's a tree, the normal distribution, or a two-way table. A good example of this is expected number calculations. So for example, in a normal distribution question, the question might say, if 500 chihuahuas are weighed, how many of them would be expected to weigh over 3 kgs? The steps you take with this are, first, you calculate the probability that one chihuahua weighs over 3 kgs, then you just multiply it by the total number you're measuring. So you multiply that probability by 500. Then at the end, you'll round that to a whole number because you can't have half a chihuahua. Another example of a skill that can come up in any question is conditional probability. It's probably one of the trickier things to wrap your head around in this exam. You can usually recognize these questions because they'll use the words if or given that. So for example, the question might say, if you're late to class, what's the probability you bought a coffee along the way? So let's say I'd already calculated that the probability that I was late was 0.25, the probability that I bought a coffee was 0.3, and the probability that I was late and I bought a coffee was 0.15. The trick to these is that the thing that you're given, the thing you know, goes on the bottom of the fraction, so that would be the probability that I'm late, and the thing you're looking for goes on the top, so that would be the times when I'm late and I bought a coffee. So we'd end up doing this where we do 0.15 divided by 0.25 and you get 0.6. So your conditional probability is 0.6. Finally, there are some common mistakes to avoid on this paper. So students will often round their answers wrong or put the wrong number of zeros in a decimal. So for example, writing 0.5 instead of 0.05. And the third common thing that we see is students not turning their answer into a percentage if the question asks for it. These are all really easy things to check for at the end of your exam to make sure you don't get penalised for silly mistakes.
While we've covered a lot of good strategies today, please note that we haven't quite covered everything. We would strongly recommend that you go through 3 to 4 past exams so you know what to expect.
You can also check out the StudyTime walkthrough guides. They're available to buy in print or for free online, and they're designed to help you ace your exam.
Good luck!